What I'm gonna show you today is how to create repeating project templates. It's probably one of the questions I get most often. Even if you're not interested in this, I'm gonna show you tons of amazing Coda tips and tricks that you can use in your own docs. Come along. All right, so to create some sort of recurring or repeating project management structure, you're actually gonna need four key tables. Let me explain to you those first. You have two different kinds. You have your template tables, and then you have the actual tables that you're gonna work from. So your template tables are templates. You get to set a template of a type of project and the types of tasks associated with it that will repeat over and over. But these are, an easy way to say it, are these aren't the things you're gonna actually check off. Okay, when we get to the actual tables you work from, you'll notice there's a project complete and a done row with a checkbox, because these are gonna be the actual tasks or projects that you mark off and work from and say, I am complete. So let's look at the structure of these first. You only need a few things. The key is that you're going to need to connect your tasks to your projects. And you do that with a relation column. So what I'm gonna do is create another task. So if we're going to clean the kitchen, another thing that we might want to do is to organize the fridge, right? And now I get to say what kind of project this is connected to. This is connected to clean the kitchen. You'll notice that this is a relation type column that's right here, and it's relating to projects or project templates specifically. I also have created a two-way linked relation so that when I mark it here, you'll notice that it came up here. So those are our four tasks. And what we're gonna do now that we have this is we just need a button that is going to actually generate your projects and your tasks down below. And then you'll need this special row called create project row. So here we go. Let me press this start button. You'll see what happens. When I press start, you'll notice that what happened down here is it created this project with its associated tasks in the tables that I actually work from. You can see that I can press it again, and you'll notice that it created a new Clean the Kitchen project with its own new tasks. And now you can actually come here and you can actually clean the kitchen and you can manage this as a project all on its own. So that is really, really cool. That's essentially the structure that it works from, right? And you can create as many of these as you want. You might want to do one that's wash the car, and its tasks are going to be, let's create a couple more. We're going to clean outside, and we're going to clean inside. And let's put that on wash the car, and let's put that on wash the car. And you'll see that I can start this now, and that pushes that into there as a new project for you. So that's how it works. And if you just wanna grab this template, you don't really care about how did I actually do this in Coda, you can just grab that template in the comment section below or in the descriptions. But I think you're gonna wanna stick around. I'm gonna show you how and why I did this and the thinking behind it so that you can kind of recreate these structures on your own for your own unique workflows. So let's look at that now. First off is just this button. This button is called start this project. Now I'm gonna recreate it from scratch because I think that's a bit easier to do. So what I did is I created a column type button. And what that button did is I said, hey button, can you go ahead and add a row when pressed to the projects table? And you're gonna set the value of the name, the project name, as equal to this row dot name, okay? But this is really important, and this is where this next step allows you to essentially complete this whole workflow. You're gonna set a results column, and I'm gonna set that to a new column, and that's called added rows. What that results column does for you is it stores the actual row that was created into it. So you'll notice here, I have that same thing on here. If I press delete, that's empty, but when I press start, it pops a row here. Where does this row come from? This row comes specifically from our projects table, okay? So what I did now though is I've got to be able to add the task. That only adds the project, but how do we add the actual tasks? Well, what I did is I came into my button and I transferred this visual editor into a formula. So I'm gonna pop this formula up nice and big for us. And what you're actually gonna do is I'm gonna copy all this, copy, and I'm gonna wrap it into a new Coda formula called RunActions. You can actually see a whole video on RunActions. It's a 2-minute quick tip I have, tells you about it, but essentially all it does is allows us to make a single button do multiple things. So that's the first thing it's going to do. The second thing we want it to do is to, so now we want it to add the actual tasks for this project and connect those tasks to the newly created project. So notice that on here I have task template. These are all the rows associated with this row. So I'm gonna take into this button and I'm gonna run into it and say, all right, what is it gonna do? It's gonna take the task template dot for each of those in there, right? So that's saying, hey, for each task connected to this project, I want you to add a row to tasks, the tasks table, and I want you to set the name to the current value dot task, and I want you to set the connected project to the added rows. What is the added rows? The added rows, if you remember, is here. Let's auto format this, makes that nice. The added rows section is where we store what was just created. So it's saying, what it's saying is, what projects that I connect this task to, and we're saying, hey, can you please go and connect this task to the newly created project, right? So now we have this big formula in here that's essentially saying, first, let's go ahead and create the new project from this template. And then we're saying, now that you've done that, add the actual task to this project and connect those tasks to the newly created project. So that's how we're gonna do that. But if you stick around, because I'm gonna show you one more thing, how you can actually cause these to repeat automatically on a custom schedule. All right, the last thing we know is how to actually repeat these automatically based off a custom schedule. So what we're gonna do first is we're gonna come into our table. I've already built the column. It's just called repeat on. It's very simple. I'm gonna say this is gonna repeat. When do we want these things to repeat? Maybe we clean this every Monday, and maybe we clean the car every Thursday. What I'm gonna do now is just set an automation in my document that is going to actually run every single day, time-based. Let's make it run every day. And what we're gonna say is, you know, make it run at whatever time you want. But then what we're going to do is actually run a custom then thing. And what we're gonna say is, we're gonna say project templates.filter. So hey, look at my project templates table and only give me certain rows. Give me the ones where repeat on is equal to today.weekday name. So you'll notice that right now that returns nothing right here. It's saying I'm not finding any. I'm recording this on a Wednesday. So let's change this to Wednesday. Repeat on Wednesday. And now if I do that, you'll see that it's pulling clean the kitchen. And then we're gonna say, okay, with those rows, what do we want this to do? We want it to start this project. And that is it. Now you can turn your rule on. If you test it, you'll notice that I have clean the kitchen, clean the kitchen, clean the kitchen. Test this rule and it would press that button once. And that is all you need to do to create repeating project templates. You could also use this as just repeating tasks with subtasks as well, or really any other type of structure that you are looking for. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Make sure to click subscribe. Let me know if you got any questions in the comments. Adios.